Okay, today we're going to be replacing the edge guard on a paddle. Sometimes we see them crop and you get a broken piece. This is something that can be repaired. Sometimes you'll see those little pieces fall off. Not a big deal. This is something that's fixable. Tools that we're going to need. Number one, an edge guard. Today we're going to be using a 14 millimeter. We're going to want a pair of heavy duty snips. Your regular household kitchen scissors probably won't work, so you need heavy duty snips or tin snips, possibly a needle nose plier, pair of pliers, file, heat gun. Optional is you can do it two ways, either with hot glue, or today we're going to try using E6000. Okay, so to get started, first thing we need to do is remove the old grip. Set that aside for later use, possibly. Now we're going to run and remove the old edge guard. This is where the pliers come in. Kind of just break it away from there. Okay, so now we see the raw edge guard. We do want to clean it up, get any loose pieces or old glue off of there. A little rough on the edge, something for the glue to stick to. Okay, once we get that cleaned up, we're going to take our edge guard, make sure it fits. We're going to start it at the base of the paddle, underneath where the grip would go. And see that we do have the proper size. Okay, that's going to work nicely. From here, now I'm going to put it on for good. I'm going to tack it with the hot glue. Gives a little better adhesion. Sets up immediately, so you don't have to wait for it to dry. Just hold that for a second. Make sure that adheres nicely. Okay, the glue set. Next thing I'm going to do is prep my glue. You can do the whole rim slowly with the hot glue. E6000 weighs a little bit less, won't add any extra weight. Pop the top. I like to use an applicator tip because I put a nice clean bead down. Now, just to help this be a little bit more flexible, I'm going to use a heat gun. And you can start feeling this starting to get hot. That'll just help it be a little bit more flexible. With my glue, I'm going to put a bead on the inside here. And then come back and get the other side. And I'm not going to do the last little bit because I'm going to use hot glue down there as well. Okay, I'm going to press this onto the paddle. If you kind of roll it back, the edges will open up. Alright, we have a little extra at the end here. We're going to want to cut that. This is where a heavy duty scissor or a snip will work best for you. I'm going to come back with hot glue. Put a little bit on the bottom. And you just hold that till it sets up. Pretty good. There's no loose edges here. If you use an E6000 or glue that doesn't dry instantly, just put a little tape to hold it on. All right, we're going to set that down, let that set up to dry for about an hour, and we'll come back and finish it up. Okay, so our glue should have set up now. We'll remove the tape holding it on. One note that I used a hot glue down on this part. If you don't have a hot glue, I recommend that you tape around this area as well as around the rim. Just make sure you hold those two end areas in. I'm going to look for a little chunks that we had in there. Clean these off. And we're ready to put the grip back on. Normally I'd like to use a new grip when I do this, but for the sake of this video, we're going to try to use what we had. We have our old grip. We'll try to recycle everything. take a piece of that tape. Tape the edge of this just so it doesn't fall off. Then we'll start going around. You want to get a good overlap on that first bit. Once you get about halfway past it, you'll start to go up the paddle. Come up here. And then we'll finish it with the remaining tape. And there we go. Good as new. New room protector. And we're using the old grip.